Hello everyone, this is Crypto Coin Investor. Today I'm going to talk about the four new Monero forks. So the Monero just hard forked it and it resulted in four new projects. Yes, one hard fork later and there are four new Monero projects. So for those who don't know, privacy-centric cryptocurrency Monero hard forked to version 12 of its protocol day before yesterday. And this is not a new thing. Monero hard forks after every 6 months and it disregards the old coins, the old blockchain, and moves to the new one. This time, however, it was different because four new coins were made. And now there is Monero Classic, XMC, Monero Zero, XMZ, Monero Original, XMO, and Monero Classic, XMC. The Monero Classic was initiated by a group of individuals in Singapore. This group of individuals believe in the ASIC machine. They think that the development of ASICs is a healthy market-driven process. The Monero Classic's website claims that the Monero Classic already has a multitude of partners in place, although it is unclear how things will go on from here on out. And then we have Monero Zero. This new hard fork currency wants to remove itself from the actual Monero development branch. The latest hard fork has been proverbial last straw for the people backing the Monero Zero project. Their vision revolves around using the Satoshi's proof of work for the foreseeable future, which seems to welcome the ASIC miners, causing major centralization in the mining ecosystem. The interesting part is the Monero Zero claims itself to be the original Monero, which goes back to version 11. There is no pre-mine and existing Monero holders will have an equivalent balance of Monero Zero. Unfortunately, the team has not implemented replay protection. So keep that in mind before claiming Monero Zero using your Monero's original private key. Now let's talk about Monero Original, which has XMO as its ticker. This fork of Monero does not even have a website, so there's much less information about it. They do have a GitHub page for the project. The developer behind this project says that they are giving the users an opportunity to stay with the original chain. They think that the team stands for diversity, which is a logical marker of evolution. Interestingly, while they do not have any website, they already have gathered support from big exchanges like HitBTC, so it will be interesting to see how this fares out in future. Interestingly, another fork has called itself Monero Classic. This one also has the same ticker, XMC, and this one was started by another Monero enthusiast group called PZ. In a similar script to that presented by the Singapore developers, the PZ was of the view that the ASIC miners are a natural result of free market economy. They say that had there been professional mining machines, the 500,000 botnet attack could have been avoided. Of course, one should view this as a project with an air of suspicion. This is because one of the pools that is supporting the XMC's ant pool, which is basically backed by Bitmain. This is the very company that is making these mining machines. So, should you claim these free coins? Well, currently, it does not seem as if any of these alternative coins will have any potential to challenge the new version of Monero. Also, the replay protection is not even implemented in some of these forks. So, keep that in mind as well. So, that's all about it. I hope you liked my video. Irrespective of the risk that could have been presented by the hard fork, it seems that it was indeed a success. The mining hashing power is returning to the original chain and many in the community are cautiously optimistic about it. This hard fork was a tight slap to the Bitmain company and they will definitely be thinking twice before challenging a determined community like Monero. I hope you liked my video. Give us a like and share with your friends. Stay subscribed for more cryptocurrency and ICO news. Bye bye.